Now, I have two dogs at home, and they hate any type of storm, big or small. They don't like it. They'll run under beds, run under couches, or even just shake throughout the whole thing. If you're anything like me and you have dogs like this, you also dread any stormy forecast. Now, my next guest this morning, she's an experienced veterinarian here in the Keys. She's going to tell us all about her practice, along with giving us some advice on how to keep our pets happy and prepared for any tropical storm. Lisa, thank you for being with me this morning.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Well, it's wonderful having you here, and I'll have you start by telling our viewers about your experience as a vet here in the Keys.
Okay, well, let's see. I started down here in the Keys in 1991 when I graduated from University of Florida, and I've been at All Animal Clinic since 1992. We used to be located over on Fifth Avenue next to the Rusty Anchor, and 5 years ago we moved here closer to your facility on McDonald, right there by the bank and the Pepsi place in that little strip mall.
Okay, and now let's talk about All Animal Clinic. What services do you provide?
We provide a full variety of services. Everything, basically anything you can imagine. And we do surgery, we do medicine, we have a groomer there, we're on call for emergency 24/7, we're there in the middle of the night a lot. We have a lot of specialists that work with us. We have a radiologist that comes in and does ultrasounds. We have digital x-ray, the same type of equipment they use at the universities. We have that same system. We do a lot of preventative care, a lot of client education, because education is key. The more you know, the easier it is to keep your pet healthy and safe. And it's always easier to keep them healthy and safe first than to try and treat them second.
Right. Well, now, speaking of education, let's talk about, you know, we are in hurricane season. So what are some tips or advice for pets during any possible tropical storms?
Oh, there's a lot to know. First of all, my advice is when school gets out, get your pets ready. Make sure their vaccines are all current. Make sure you have proof that they're vaccinated with all your licenses and your tags in case you're going to travel and in case you're going to need to board them. After that, if your pets are on medication, make sure you have 2 to 3 months supply at all times. So when school gets out, get your pets ready.
Okay.
And that makes that part easier. As for the actual storm, if you're going to stay here, and down here in the Keys, it's year-round thunderstorms. So there's a lot of questions people ask about, what do I do when my dog is scared? You know, my dog doesn't like thunderstorms. My dog used to tolerate them, and now he or she is getting worse. There's no one fix for any pet.
Really?
They're all different. There's a lot of natural things you can try, the rescue remedy and things like that. And some people swear by it, and others, it will make no difference to the dogs. There are people that like to use those thunder shirts.
Our dog has one of those.
So that kind of mimics them being held, and they like that. But I don't know, when those storms get really bad, I don't know that it's really enough for them. We've tried your more natural melatonin, Xanax even, which, not that that's natural, but it doesn't have the same effect as it does on people. So it doesn't, and their doses are so much higher. So when you phone it into the pharmacist usually looks at us like we're crazy, but their metabolism is so different. So you have to do a much higher dose, and if it works at all, it works for like 2 hours, in my experience. So we usually go just to sedatives, to be honest. And if you have the sedatives there, if you see on that radar it's going to be a cruddy day, sedate your dog.
And does that have any side effects on the dog?
Only if they have an underlying medical condition. So there are some seizure dogs, we would use a different sedative, or dogs with heart conditions, we might change the dose or the drug that we're using because we don't want their blood pressure too low. But for the most part, the dogs get worse with time, not better. And then some people will think, well, I have a new dog, this dog will teach that dog not to be afraid, and usually, unfortunately, it's the other way around. The dog just mimics the behavior of the older dog.
Right. So those are a lot of myths that you've just kind of uncovered then.
I don't know that it's myths. It's just when you see so many numbers, and I don't have the science study to back what I'm saying. I'm just telling you what I've seen in my practice.
Now, along with school is also starting, along with it being hurricane, school's here. Do you ever have any pets that will come into you and it's like they have a hard time adjusting to maybe the kids that they had spent all summer with now being away?
Oh, yeah, they get lonely. Mm-hmm. They start acting out. Mm-hmm. Dogs that aren't used to being left alone will start chewing, or maybe even separation anxiety mm-hmm. symptoms, where they kind of go to the windows and paw at the blinds. And
right.
So it might be a good idea to kind of start prepping those dogs a couple of weeks before school gets back in. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe just leaving the house for 5 minutes, walking outside, going to the mailbox without the dog, and then coming back in so the dog doesn't really realize the change that's going to happen.
Mm-hmm. Dogs don't like change, just like people don't like
change,
right? No,
they don't. Not at all.
All right. And of course, for more information on All Animal Clinic, Lisa, they can check out your website, which is located at the bottom of the screen. They can also call the number on the bottom of the screen.
Anytime.
Okay.
Anytime.
Are you guys, well, you're always on call, and then you're open normal business hours.
We're open 7 days a week now.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So we're, when people call, we say about, they say, what time are you closing? Around 5. It's very Keys-ish.
Okay.
So it's pretty much 8 to 5, mm-hmm. Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. We're open until 8 p.m. on Wednesday evenings for the people that work, if they have to come in. We're open Saturdays 9 to 5 and Sundays about 9 to 4.
Wonderful. So. All right. Well, thank you for sharing all of this information with our viewers this morning. I'm going to take a quick break. I'll be right back after these messages. Stay with me.